Hello everyone, this is Rehan Hooda from India Today Gaming. Today we have a very special guest with us for an interaction. Please join us in welcoming Vivek Raina, the CEO of Excitel Broadband. Vivek previously worked with Hathway Broadband and Reliance Infocom, and he has been in the industry for about 15 years. Thank you Vivek for joining us for the interaction, and I guess let's just get started with the questions.
Thanks Rehan, let's start.
So the first question is obviously regarding COVID. COVID has changed lives of people all around, and it has also changed how people consume the internet. We have seen increasing shift towards video consumption and gaming. So what has Excitel seen on in terms of observations from an ISP end, and how are things different from pre-pandemic times?
Okay, so it's quite interesting question, because for us, COVID represents a black swan event from where everything sort of changed. Prior to COVID and COVID-induced lockdown happening, wireline broadband sale was effectively a concept sale. You needed to make people understand why wireline, why do you need wire in these days of mobile internet, how is it better, what things that you can do with this and not with the mobile internet, so on and so forth. So every sale, you had to actually sell this concept of wireline broadband. And then, as you said, COVID happened and COVID-induced lockdown happened, and suddenly people realized that there are so many applications, so many things that you can only do with wireline and not with mobile internet. So as soon as people got confined to their homes, then working from home, video conferencing, then schools from home for children, then consuming these massive amounts of data for OTT consumption and so on and so forth. This is not something which a mobile broadband, any mobile broadband, 4G, 5G or any G can handle. It is for wireline broadband, and therefore you need wireline broadband. This became very evident to people at large because of COVID-induced lockdown. And people realized that wireline broadband is just a utility. It is a utility. It's not a luxury anymore. It's like electricity, water and gas. You need wireline broadband in the home, and proper wireline broadband in at home. And this thing was done by COVID. This concept clearance in people at large was done by COVID. And obviously there was a lot of demand, uptake in demand. I mean, it started even pre-lockdown when mostly MNCs and tech companies started shifting their people to homes and told them to work from homes. The demand started having upswing. And then obviously when actual lockdown was announced and people got confined to their homes, it was huge demand. So it was like a challenge for us initial days to actually fulfill the demand, simply because we were also reeling under the lockdown. And then we got passes, we got ourselves declared as essential service, we got passes, and some of us could move around. So for example, now Excitel has few thousand people working for it in Delhi. You cannot give few thousand passes. But then we gave identity cards to try to resolve issues on the ground, so on and so forth. So in few weeks, we were again up and running. And then we were just fulfilling the demands. That was one thing. But then at the same time, now that you're sort of using internet so much, and for everything you are sort of dependent on internet, the quality of service also needs to be better. The performance also needs to be better. And your service assurance or service resolution also needs to be faster. So this was another challenge during lockdown. You needed to up your game there also, while reeling under the effects of the lockdown and while saving ourselves from getting sick and so on and so forth. So it was quite interesting, quite challenging, yet fulfilling in many ways. Fulfilling because ultimately at the end of the day, you realize that entire country is literally caged in their homes, and this is the only way with which they are connecting to the world, having some semblance of normalcy, or spending time, and therefore there's a role that you have to play in doing that. So it was quite interesting time. But having said that, in 6 months after the lockdown was announced, we added around 100,000 connections to the existing base of 3.5 that we had. And now it has been like 7, 8, 9 months ever since this thing happened, and the year is closing, and we are about to touch 5 lakh users. So in that way, the demand has been tremendous, the growth has been tremendous, but the challenges have also been tremendous, and we had to basically improve ourselves a lot in order to fulfill these expectations of the people that COVID brought.
Okay, and anything in terms of the type of usage that you may have seen?
Primarily, as I said, suddenly people started working from their homes. Kids started attending schools from their homes. So a lot of video interaction content, a lot of, you know, video conferencing. I mean, it was a huge, I think 700-800% increase in video interactions happened. Then a lot of OTT consumption. I mean, this also increased multiple times over because people have had time now to sort of watch these things over. And then obviously gamers got a lot of time to play games now. Yeah. Extra time they had. So gaming, I would say video conferencing, video consumption and gaming in that order.
Okay, cool. I also read that Excitel was planning to expand to 100 cities before lockdown happened and all. So, and we have already seen the ISP in a couple of major cities across India. So, and I'm sure that COVID actually may have, you know, impacted the expansion plans. But any details on what we can see in terms of expansion in 2021?
We're already in around 9 to 10 cities. We're in Delhi. We're always in Delhi. And then we're in Hyderabad. We opened Bangalore. We're in Lucknow, Kanpur, Jaipur. But from going forward, we need to sort of concentrate on B-class towns, you know, state capitals and smaller towns. This is the area where we will sort of like to spread. And in next 5 months, 5 to 6 months, we will open 15 such towns and cities. And then going forward, let's say in a year and a run down the line, again 50 odd such cities. So yeah, okay. we are moving, we are improving, we are sort of expanding at the same time. Yet obviously we are now very cautious so that we deliver the quality of services wherever we go and maintain the same standard of fiber to home.
Cool. Excitel already offers multiple plans like for gamers up to 300 Mbps with fiber to home connections with impressive pics. I personally have seen like 1-2 MS and that's like usual. Any plans to take things to the next level for gamers in the future?
You see, fundamentally we are suffering from the gaming scene is suffering from the same issue which video was suffering, let's say, 4 years back.
Yeah.
The speeds of video were not enough and therefore video was not picking up because there was a lot of streaming. So video streaming was very, very, you know, small in India. And then the speeds increased, networks got better. So consumption of video started. Similarly, gaming is next level, I would say, after the video.
Yeah.
And therefore, you know, if this 300, and I don't know whether you know or not, but then this 300 Mbps plan that we have, now if somebody subscribes for a year, it's for $4.99. So this is the cheapest ever gaming plan in the country right now. Such speed at this rate, nobody, offers. At the same time, we are offering it across all geographies within a city. This is another specialty of Excitel. We don't focus on that 15-20% where everybody else goes, which is like upmarket areas, multi-story buildings, or, you know, proper planned areas where the population of the city goes. We focus on 70% of Bharat, so-called Bharat, you know, versus India, where there are no proper streets, there are no proper back lanes. And we are offering these services, high gaming plans at 500 rupees for these mass to sort of enjoy gaming. And we basically, gaming will take off only when you make it available for masses, when it doesn't remain a niche product, which is right now.
Yeah.
You know, you make people experience it like video. I mean, it was a niche thing. Now everybody in every slum in India has a mobile phone and they watch YouTube or other content on that.
Yeah.
So same with gaming. You need to, take this service at affordable rates to all pockets of urban India. And then you'll see it will take off. Once it takes off, and the demand for higher speeds and higher, you know, versions comes, we will be there to fulfill it. But as of now, our whole focus is to spread it, to percolate it to all areas of urban India at affordable prices.
Multiple companies across India have jumped into the fiber to home scene, including Reliance with Jio Fiber, Act, Airtel and more. And I guess you previously worked with Hathway and Jio Infocom. So what plans do you have to differentiate, the Excitel from the competition?
So fundamentally, a few things I would like to add there. First and foremost, as you rightly said, that I worked in Hathaway as well as Reliance Infocom in its previous avatar. So most of these companies, with companies I mean traditional ISPs or telcos, they focus on specific pockets of the city, as I told you in my answer of the first previous question.
Yeah.
The first thing you do is a survey of the city and see which are the higher income pockets, and you try to sort of plan your network in just those pockets. Once you sort of have suitable penetration there, then you go to some other pockets. So that's one differentiator. In our case, we don't do that. We are here for masses. We are here for 70-80% of urban India. Since we go through partners, our last mile delivery is through partners. And these partners are usually local cable operators. So these local cable operators operate in all areas of the cities, whether it's high income group, lower income group, multi-stories or slums. And we have control on the way they lay their network because we provide them the maps to lay the network. And we also provide the electronics in it. And this partner has to just pull the cable and maintain the cable.
Yeah. Okay.
So our delivery of service and our reach is much wider than any of the traditional telco that you name. And the areas that they don't think about currently are the areas where we revel. This is the area where 70% of urban population lives in. And this is our target group also. This is where we want to sort of provide this world-class FTTH-based service at affordable prices. We want this digital exclusion that has existed in the country for many years, in real sense, we want to kill it, and we want to basically integrate these people. These people also have aspirations as much as anywhere else, or as many as, so these aspirations need to be met, and their needs need to be fulfilled through this world-class service that we are offering at affordable prices. So I think the model that we are deploying, and also many of these traditional ISPs have still legacy infrastructure. They're trying to change it slowly, but it's a slow and gradual process for them because they have a lot of legacy to change. In our case, we don't have any such legacy, and we have already stopped all legacy sales. From 30th or 31st of December, Excitel will not be selling any legacy copper connection anymore. It will be 100% FTTH sale alone. Okay. And by the end of 2021, we will finish all our existing legacy connections also and convert them to fiber. So it will be 100% FTTH company. And it will be with this solid backbone, we will reach all areas of the city and provide them equal service at affordable rates and perhaps faster speeds than our competitors. So yeah, that's what it is. It's not just about Delhi. It's about each and every city in India. It's about B-class, C-class towns where people want, are hungry for these speeds, are hungry for consumption of data, or hungry for gaming. But they don't have any access to it. They have to rely on these patchy legacy networks. Yeah. And Excitel wants to bring this FTTH service at affordable rates in such areas, such cities, across the country.
Sure, cool. Moving towards somewhat future in terms of gaming, we have seen cloud gaming take off in multiple countries across the globe. And as you rightly mentioned, that gaming is not really a mainstream when it comes to India, and it has to do more with the access to gaming. So what do you think is a responsibility of an ISP to, make things mainstream, especially for cloud gaming, which will be more helpful for people without access to powerful hardware?
Precisely. I think first and foremost, what we lack in this country, I don't know whether we have around 2 crore wireline connections in the country. For a population of 1.2 billion, 2 crore households getting connected to wireline broadband is really a sorry figure. So first and foremost, responsibility of an ISP is to bring this infra, bring this fiber pipe to each and every household, to connect as many households as possible in urban, semi-urban areas to start with, and then go forward to rural areas if it can be. But the first thing is to bring these high quality fiber pipes to households, and that's what we're bringing. Once you bring these pipes, the data limit should not be a thing. to be worried about. Speed should not be something that the customer is worried about. Then you'll see video consumption, gaming, you know, online working. It will take off like anything. Right now, the whole pie is so limited, and therefore the gaming is becomes niche within that pie. So you just have to increase the size of the pie. And again, I repeat, this country has a lot of latent talent, latent potential, latent aspirations that we need to fulfill by connecting households as soon as possible. I think this is the first thing we need to do, you know, without moving around much. This is we need to connect as many as households with these fiber pipes as possible.
Okay, cool. Also, I guess you already mentioned about speeds, but when can we expect gigabit speeds from Exitel? If and when there are any rough plans about it, like 1 year down the line, 2 years down the line?
So, you see, it again depends on user response. It again depends on the users wanting it. As of now, you know, even 300 Mbps speed has like 5% takers in Exitel ecosystem. We will obviously take a step ahead and go to 500 first, and then see the response there. The fact is that the more people, the more you spread, the more there will be people who will want these niche speeds because of gaming and other things. The more would be a pressure on us to deliver. Yeah. So it is directly proportional to how much we spread. And yes, in next 1 year, well, let's hope we reach there.
Okay, cool, awesome. Final question: what trends do you foresee when it comes to gaming space in Indian market from a point of view of an ISP?
So cloud-based gaming, as you rightly said, is another thing that we have to be very cognizant about. And now, this is only going to increase the amount of data that people are going to require for new games that are coming on. And I think if I see 3-4 years down the line, is just a start. You are going to have hologram games, you're going to have virtual reality games, and so forth. So the data hunger is only going to increase. So therefore, it is pertinent to have capacity already there. You need to have infra that can deliver this gaming. You need to think of that time when you have to deliver 1 gig for every household, as you rightly said, and create your infra using that imagination, rather than thinking what purpose I'm serving right now. That's not going to help you, because these trends are going to change. There will be hologram, there will be virtual reality, that will require 5 times more bandwidth. So you need to lay your fiber or infra right now and be ready for that.
Okay, cool. I'll add one more question to the mix. What changes do you want, or what support do you want from the stakeholders in the ISP space or the telecom space to help you grow net of connectivity or serviceability in a faster manner?
So I think as it is, in last 4-5 years, there have been tremendous changes that have taken place in the ecosystem, with the proliferation of internet exchanges, caching services, peering services coming in, and this ecosystem is emerging. I think all stakeholders have to encourage this ecosystem, independent ecosystems to emerge, independent internet exchanges to emerge, independent peering services to emerge. The more they proliferate, the more there will be, the more we can deliver to the customer at affordable price. See, it's no challenge to deliver 10 megabits or 10 gigabit service at, let's say, 5,000 rupees. But that's not where the market is. Market is at 500 rupees. You have to deliver effective service of 100 or more Mbps of speed at 500 rupees. And for that, you need this ecosystem. For that, you need exchanges. For that, you need caching, pairing. And that ecosystem, everybody needs to support. And this will help us, proliferate broadband or increase penetration of broadband from this dismal levels right now. A lot of independent players doing independent things in exchanges and pairings, cachings. This will help us. And also interoperability, exchange of traffic between ISPs also needs to be encouraged to a great extent, so that we localize as much as traffic as possible and are able to give as much as to the customer in this 500 rupees. That's my ballpark figure. And that's critical to maintain high capacity, to deliver high speed without any limits at affordable prices to masses. And that's how internet ultimately, or broadband ultimately, will have some penetration in the country.
Okay. Thanks a lot, Vivek, for joining us for the chat, and thank you for all the insights that you shared. And we hope for things to accelerate in the coming future. And all the best for to Excitel for the future.
Thanks, Ryan. Pleasure.